Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm taking you guys grocery shopping with me. So when most of my friends call me and they see me eating stuff like gari or any other African food, they're always like, you're eating indomie, you're eating gari, how do you get it, where do you buy it from? So today I'm going to show you guys where I buy it from. You're coming with me for grocery shopping. I look cute, I know. That's because I don't get to look fine anymore because there's nowhere to go to, and I usually don't dress nice to work. So grocery shopping is the only place I actually have the opportunity to wear my nice clothes too. And hence this outfit which my roommate gave to me. Oh, by the way, if you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. So yeah, let's go shopping. So I decided to come to Wazobia African Market because I was in the area and I decided to stop by at this one. So this is normally not the one I shop at, but hey. So this is the entrance of the store. Okay, so we need to pick the cart. But this is what grocery shopping in the United States look like technically. It's just like a regular American grocery store. And look, they have watermelon, which I'm not buying, but okay. So we have water on this side, and I love that painting, it's so pretty. And I don't know why my roommate is laughing at me, but okay. Okay, so this is how we buy our leaves. In the fridge here, you see they have cassava leaves. I don't know what that is. Cassava leaves. But then we have fever leaves. There are even some leaves that don't even exist right here. Oh, and there's water leaves. This one I know. I use this one to cook. We have scent leaves too. So it's all frozen. It's not fresh. So we don't get to enjoy the fresh leaves. And then it comes to this side of the fridge. We have pap ogi. Yellow ogi, white ogi, green pap, corn. Okay, so we have frozen spinach. Basically all our leaves are frozen except to go to stores like HEB, which I'll go to later on. And then we also have okra, also frozen, so we can try to make good okra soup. So now on this side of the store we have tomatoes, coconuts, pepper. Oh, we actually have fresh okra too right there. And this is cocoyam. Then if you want to buy it, just wait. But then I'm not buying cocoyam today, so no, I'm not wearing it. And then there's onions here, but the thing is I don't buy my onions and the rest from this store. I buy it at an American grocery store. In the freezer too, they have utazi leaves, oha leaf, odoli, I don't know what that is. But it's an African store, so it's not only Nigerian food that's going to be here. Look at this thing. I don't know, it's called bitter balls. We have that here too. So practically we have almost everything, just most of it is frozen, most especially the leaves. And then look, we have plantain, which is looking like I'm not going to buy it, and that's the price for plantain. Now coming forward to this side, more onions, more pepper, and then here is fresh spinach, which doesn't look that fresh. I'd rather buy the frozen one. More pepper. And then we can also buy eggs if we want from here, but I don't buy my eggs from the African store. Then we have different flavors of indomie. I think I'll probably buy indomie today because my indomie is about finishing. Chicken curry, different flavors of indomie noodles. And when I actually tell you guys I'm eating indomie, I'm for real, I'm actually eating indomie. So now on this side we have sardines. This is sardine I buy, Titus. And then we have pepper soup spice, corned beef. On this side we have various spices that we use in Nigeria. We have Cameroon peppers, pepper soup spice, curry, suya, thyme. So yeah, basically you don't miss home. We don't miss home that much because we actually have a lot of stuff here. Look, we even have the gnaw thingy. I feel like we need to even buy gnaw. Yeah. And then we need to buy oil, but we'll buy it from, what's it called? And then even this tiger curry or lion curry and everything. I love using that to cook. Curry and thyme. And then on this side we have peanut butter, and then we have St. Louis sugar, which is indigenous to Nigeria, I think. And then blue band butter. So basically, it's like I'm in Nigeria when I technically am not. And then here we have agege bread. This bread is the plug. Jolly Jolly bread is like the best thing that's happened to me in this country because it's actual agege bread. And it's sweet. Oh, okay, I don't know how to explain this, but this bread is everything. And then look, we have peanuts. Look, we have geisha, custard, golden morn, cerilac. Okay, I still have some cerilac at home, so I'm not buying today. And then on this side, we have Milo, Lipton, ginger tea. Basically, this is like shopping in any regular Nigerian store. Pink milk, cowbell milk. Oh my gosh, you have cowbell milk. I haven't, like I said, this is the first time shopping in this particular location, so I'm seeing things that I normally don't see. So this is how we buy our palm oil. It's already bottled like this, and it comes from different companies, so you actually like can choose whichever one you want to choose. And then we also have egusi, so you can buy your egusi like this and then blend it. And then we have dried leaves too, like this, like dry oha leaves, dry hot pepper. Okay, look, grounded egusi. So you can actually buy the grounded egusi too. And this here is how we buy our meat and fish. You just select whatever you want and then it's weighed and then you pay for it. So this tilapia, Titus. And this is how we buy our meat. Turkey, I think it's turkey or vulture, I don't know, but it looks like turkey. This is frozen chicken. There are some stores you can go to and then actually get the chicken, like the live chicken or the live goat, and then they kill it for you. Here is already cut meat that's put in the freezer, just because anybody wants to just come and it's in the hurry, you pick it and go. And then this is my best part, yam. So we have yam here too. Yeah, this one looks okay. Good. And then we have malts. We have African drinks here. We have Vita malt, Power malt, Super malt, different types of malts. Look who's a boost. So this is why I'm like, we basically eat the same thing we eat in Nigeria. Just sometimes not that fresh, but still the same thing. There's even origin bitters. Alomo bitters. Oh, that's not Alomo bitters. Yeah, Alomo bitters. Yeah, there are more bitters right here. This is basically how we shop for rice. We buy it in bags. I still have enough rice at home, so I'm not buying rice today. But it's here how we shop for rice. So we still have other drinks. Let me see this. Oh, we have Ribena, which is definitely indigenous to Nigeria. See? Ribena. And then look at it, like I showed you before. And then some American drinks. And then this is how, if you just want to, like, you know, quickly come pick something, there's stew here if you just want to come pick it and you're in a hurry. There's prepared goat's meat, there's rice, jollof rice, fried rice. You can just pick any of these ones if you're in a hurry. And then on this side now we have plantain chips, so you can always buy these and keep in your house and munch on it. Like, we even have spicy ones. So bro, you don't really get to meet. Look, there's chinchin here. Buy chinchin or anything. So this is just what your typical African store looks like. Maggi cube, I say Maggi cube. Milo cubes. I actually just have this one at the house. If I buy it now, I'll finish it before I get home. So no. Then we also have like some Nigerian biscuits. Like Olivetive, Olabit. I don't know how to pronounce that. And there's some Nigerian chocolates too. And then Pearly G. I love this biscuit so much. And then this peanuts, whatever. Basically, we have almost everything, but not everything, but almost everything. So now to this side is the part I love so much, because this is where we have gari. And it's not just any gari, it is Ijebu gari to be precise. You can see different companies make it, some have different, like, a selection to choose from. We also have fufu. So fufu flour, plantain fufu, cocoyam fufu, regular fufu, and then we have elubo right here. So if you want to make elubo, we have elubo, semolina, I don't know what this is, corn flour, wheat flour, cassava starch, in case you want to make starch. Oh, we have Ghana Gari too. So like I said, it's not just a Nigerian store, it's like an African store. We have Ijebu Gari, Ghana Gari, Yellow Gari. And then on this side, we have beans. Again, from different companies. And this is the sweet honey beans. Yeah, I said it. So if you want to cook a going beans, you can always come here and buy it. So, yeah. So any African that stays here and is telling you don't eat African food, they are lying to you. Look, there's even oat fufu. So because I actually have all these raw things, anybody that doesn't want to cook, person probably doesn't just know how to cook and doesn't want to. Pounded yam, everything. I actually have the actual yam and the pound yam. So any one of these you want to use, we can. So yeah, living here is not that hard. We still eat Nigerian food. Me personally, I do not regularly eat American food. I eat mostly Nigerian food. Oh, I forgot this section. We have expression attachments here in case you want to buy, and then Cairo white. Some African store have more of this. Look, African soaps, Dudu Osu, Sniper, for all those cockroaches in the house. But yeah, we do have cockroaches too. And you know, all this.
Who is it?
Just give me a raisin, just a little bit enough. This is basically what an irregular grocery store, an American grocery store looks like. Same thing, but bigger and has a variety of stuff. You can also find Nigerian stuff here too, because there's an international section. We didn't buy apples. Section of this grocery store, you can see they have the grosu, they have daitos, milo, and other things that we saw. You can also see in the African store it was more than this, but here they have these ones. If you're still here, thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below and give it a thumbs up so I can make more videos like this for you guys. If you would like to, like, you know, see what it's like for an African Nigerian local girl like me to live in the United States and how I survive, let me know so I can make videos about that. And if you'd like to see me try African restaurants here, also let me know and I'll definitely make those videos for you guys. But till next time, it's still me, Bethel. Bye.